driving all the way from Rochester to Salt Lake City, Utah, and I'm going to try to be back there by midnight Sunday so I can go back to work and can dig it on Monday. Let's see how we do.
There she is, lying in wait. Hefty Coronet.
It's road trip time.
First crank up. A little anxious. Want to make sure this car still runs. Might take a minute to get some fuel up to the carb.
This should be the one.
There it is. There's our girl.
It's official. She started up. Step two complete. Let's get her out. See how far we go.
Just cranked up the cat. Show her some love. Good measure. Let her run here for a minute. Give Big Bob a start up here too and show me love him too. Big old nail head. Sounds good. We'll be back for you soon, Wildcat. Behave yourself. Just cranked up Big Bob. Turned over on the first start because he's a champ. And just gonna move it to get the tires less flat spotted. And you know what that clonky sound is. When we come back, hopefully road trip it across country.
Best part.
All right, time to start this road trip. Checked out the car, topped off fluids, looking good.
I'm excited, hoping for good weather along the way and no mechanical issues. And let's do this thing. Here we go, heading out. Big moment here. Hope the car still runs good and drives good. Third gear. Alright, wish us luck. This right here is the spot where, or one of the three spots where I've lost the hood on this car. The most recent one, we redeemed it. I drove this car all the way up from North Carolina to Long Island, then Long Island up to here near Rochester, and now I'm driving all the way from Rochester to Salt Lake City, Utah. We're going to do this and aim to do it. Today is Friday, June 19th. It is 2:26 in the afternoon, and I'm going to try to be back there by midnight Sunday so I can go back to work and can dig it on Monday. Let's see how we do.
So for those of you that don't know, I bought this car from a guy in Virginia. They did a backyard tub job with like tin can aluminum. It's got a 15-gallon Anheuser-Busch keg as a fuel cell. So we're going to top off right now with some Sunoco 93 and just keep calculating along the way. This car should be getting about 13 miles to the gallon, according to my last road trip. 15 gallons, playing it safe. 15 times 10, that's 150 miles. I've got two spare 5-gallon jugs here, just in case I run out along the way. And we should be good, just staying on top of our mileage. So my neutral safety switch is acting up, so we're gonna start at the Mopar way. I came around a corner once in the Mustang and got a little too hot and wound up in that cornfield. Good memories. Point is though, the car wasn't damaged and I made it out. So far it's doing good. We're about an hour into the drive now. Kind of really start to get the nerves off a little bit. You're like, all right, I think we're gonna make it. The car feels okay. Running at 205, it's about 90 degrees, a little humid. Battery's charging good, good oil pressure. Feeling okay right now. We're gonna hit the highway now and take it from there on I-90, leave New York State. Just heading through Buffalo, doing good still. 75, it's really 65 on this thing. We just went 100 miles and we used 5.59 gallons, which is telling me I'm getting 17 miles to the gallon. That's pretty wild. Hit a little bit of traffic heading towards Erie, Pennsylvania on 90. Had to ride the shoulder a little bit to stay from overheating, but we're almost out of it. Should be clear here in about a mile, and the car is still doing really good. Very happy with it.
here, quarter windows, total game changer, air directed right to you know where. Oh, so good. Driving through Cleveland.
Day two here. The neutral safety switch and the shifter are still being faulty, so I've continued to start the car the entire rest of the trip the Mopar way. And yeah, doing good. Spotted me coming across country from Instagram and joined out here on the road to come and catch up with me. How freaking cool is that?
onto the damn side of the highway just to wait up for me to try and catch me on the road and cruise. Like, you meet such great people in the car community. You really, really do. Oh, and what a great spot to stop, too, at this airspace museum. Jim, it was great meeting you, dude. Thank you. Not as beautiful as last night, but still, great sunset. Get waves from people. People coming by, knocking and waving, families, kids. Just ran into so many cool people today. What a freaking day, man. I can't believe the car community is just amazing. I'm beside myself. On because we're gonna get through this in a minute. I know it. You can see the sunlight ahead. We good? We're good. Only took us a minute here. Like I said, not bad. Not bad at all.
Amazing ride it's been. Met some cool people along the way. What a freaking blast. so excited to be here. Even if I don't make it another mile down the road, it's already a victory. Two Mopars in the shop. That's what I'm talking about.